So this is the cooling tower we are talking about, and now whatever you are seeing is the temperature gradient inside this cooling tower. So as you can see, the blue represents a cooler temperature, right? This red represents hotter temperature, okay? And the topmost part of this cooling tower represents the ambient temperature, or somewhat greater than the ambient temperature, okay? So take this as our CPU. So here, this hot section represents the cooling fan of the processor, right? And this top area represents the fan, okay? So what this fan is doing? This is pulling out this air. So we call this forced draft effect or forced stack effect. So this is pulling this air. Anyways, the air was hot and it wanted to come out. But what this is doing, it is just forcing that air to just come out, okay? So this is how you can correlate this. So this is the fan, and it is the whole CPU cabinet. So there is a temperature difference inside the CPU cabinet because of the temperature liberated by all these electronic components, and as a result this fan is pulling there. So this is how we are making our making the CPU cabinet even more efficient, right? Even more thermally effective. Thermally we are basically improving the overall effectiveness inside the system. A fan from Cooler Master, right? So you can very well see the specs here. So if you can see the spec, so the spec says, sorry, yeah, so the spec says it's a 1200 rpm fan, right? It's a fan from Cooler Master, so it's a 1200 rpm fan. It draws 0.37 amps and it's a 12 volt fan. So before fitting this fan, let me tell you one thing. So the fan has two sides, as you can very well see. So one side is this and one is the other side, right? This one. So one side is called suction side, and the other side is called the air delivery side, right? So what this means is, from one side the fan is sucking the air, it means it is taking the air from environment, and the other side is from where the air comes out, right? So what we have to do is, in the draft effect, as I told you, so we have to put the suction side below, like in the CPU cabinet ka environment. So we'll put the suction side downwards so that it can suck the hot air from the CPU cabinet and throw it upwards. So that means that we have to put the suction side downwards and the air delivery side should be upwards. So it is throwing the air outside. So what we have to do is, we have to put it like this, right? So this side will be facing upwards towards the sky, so that whatever the air is being sucked, whatever the hot air is being sucked from the CPU cabinet, it is throwing the air upwards, right? This is the fan we are going to use on top of our CPU. So this is, and you can see there are these holes on top of this, right? So what I'm going to do is, this is our dull sided tape which we are going to use to stick the fan on the top surface, and then we will hook this from the metal cable. So I have sticked the double sided tape, the white thing which you are seeing, on the all four outside edges and on the center. And now using this, I will just stick this on the top metal surface and then hook this. Okay, let's do it. Choose the area just above the CPU ka cooling fan, like processor ka cooling fan, which is here. So I'll put it just above it so that it is more effective in pulling the hot air from that area. Okay, so see, I have sticked the fan, but you cannot leave it like this, because after some time, when the effect of the glue is not that great, then this will fall. So you have to ensure that you do some positive locking or say you do some positive arresting of this, so that if the effect of glue is not there, then also it is on its right place. And also that double-sided tape is helping as a, say, vibration absorber. So whenever dust accumulates, the fan gets some amount. So what is happening now is, what will happen because of this draft fan now, so whatever the amount of heat this is throwing out, okay, so from this heat sink, this fan is basically, when the fan is rotating, it is extracting, sucking the heat from the heat sink and throwing it outside this fan. So basically the heat which is coming out is spreading into this whole cabinet. So now this fan was already pulling the heat outside, okay, into the environment. Now see, in environmental case also, what happens whenever you put some hot object, it automatically cools down. So what happens, hot air rises. So in this case also, whatever the hot air is coming out is rising, right? Rising means it is trying to escape towards upper side, and from the upper side, from these vents which are already there, see these vents, so from these vents it is trying to escape outwards, right, into the environment. So this effect was already happening, but this fan, what it will do is, it will force that effect, it will force that draft to happen, right? It will force that draft effect to happen even more. So when it forces the air to, like when it sucks the air, then that draft effect, then we call that induced draft effect, right? So that draft effect we are inducing, we are forcing that effect to happen even more. So when that effect happens, then what happens, the hotter air is sucked from this fan, right, is sucked from this fan and then thrown upwards, and then thrown upwards. So when this effect happens, then your whole inside cabinet is even more thermally managed. Like it is, in terms of cooling of the processor, it is ensuring that the cooler is even more cool, because it is doing proper ventilation inside the cabinet. It is ensuring that no hot air remains inside the cabinet, okay? So this fan was already ensuring that hot air goes out of this cabinet. And now when I have added this fan, so because of the induced draft effect, the hot air is forced to go outside of this cabinet. So this is ensuring that the CPU is even more cooler, it works more efficiently, there are no thermal issues, okay, and this whole cabinet is even more thermally managed. So this is the benefit of adding this particular fan here.